In this video, we will consider a polyhedron in standard form, and we assume that there is no redundant constraints, that they have been eliminated, so that the matrix is of full rank. And then we will use the equality constraints to eliminate some variables and to simplify the problem. Consider this simple example. I have four variables and two constraints. Now, from the first constraint, I can write x3 equals 1 minus x1 minus x2. And from the second constraint, I can extract x4. So x4 would be equal to 1 minus x1 plus x2. Now, I can use these constraints to change the value of x3 and x4 in the objective function. So the objective function can be written x1 plus x2 plus x3, which is 1 minus x1 minus x2, plus x4, which is 1 minus x1 plus x2. So there is some simplification. So x1 cancels with this one, x2 cancels with this one. And we have also seen that constants do not matter in an objective function, so we can remove the 1 here. So we are left with an objective function which is equal to minus x1 plus x2. So we have reduced the dimensionality of the problem. We have no more equality constraints. Our objective function involves only the variables x1 and x2, but we still have the inequality constraints. And be careful, even if we have removed x3 and x4, we cannot get rid of the constraints that says that these variables must be non-negative. Let's take an example. If I take for x1 the value 3 and x2 the value 1, these are non-negative numbers, so these are feasible values for x. But now if I calculate the associated value for x3, it's equal to 1 minus 3 minus 1, which is equal to minus 3. So this is not valid. X3 cannot be negative. Even if we replace the variables using the equality constraint, we cannot forget that the original variables must stay positive. And actually, in this example, calculating x4 also leads to an infeasible value because we have 1 minus 3 plus 1, which is equal to minus 1. So we can use the equality constraints to eliminate some variables and simplify the problem, but we should not forget the original formulation because this does not eliminate the inequality constraints. Let's see how we can do this in a systematic way. We have the system of equation that characterizes the constraint, Ax equals b. A is a matrix of m rows and n columns. B is a vector of Rm, and x is a vector of Rn. We assume that the rank of the matrix is equal to m, so we have removed all the redundant constraints, if any. The way to eliminate the variables is by selecting m columns of A that are linearly independent. So basically, I need to write A as two parts, a part which I have m columns, and a part which I have n minus m columns. So the first m columns must be linearly independent. Why? Because then B would be a square matrix, and because the columns are linearly independent, this square matrix will be invertible, and it will happen to be useful. But we don't have necessarily to choose the first m columns, like I put in this example. So what we could do is to make a permutation of the columns so that we put the columns that we desire to consider in the beginning. So the general way to write the same decomposition is by saying, let's permute the columns of the matrix A. So P is a permutation matrix. If you remember, a permutation matrix is the identity matrix such that the columns have been permuted. And this permuted matrix is decomposed into a square matrix B with m rows and m columns, and a matrix N which has m rows and n minus m columns. So P is a permutation matrix, so it means that P times P transpose is the identity matrix. So now we can rewrite the equality constraints. using this decomposition. We have Ax. So let's use now the fact that P times P transpose is equal to I. So this can be written AP P transpose X. And I can consider the two parts here. AP, we just saw that it's a matrix which is decomposed into two parts, a square matrix B and a matrix N. And P transpose X is nothing else than the set of variables which has been renumbered in order to be consistent with the new numbering of the columns of the matrix. So what we will do is that we will write X subscript B to consider the M components of the vector X, which corresponds to the M columns of B, and Xn, which will be the other components of the vector X, those that correspond to the columns of N. So this can be written B times XB plus N times Xn. And this must be equal to B to verify the constraints. And now we are in a position that we can eliminate the variables XB using the equation that we have just written. We have that B XB equals to B minus N of Xn. And now we can multiply by the inverse of B, and this exists because capital B is square, and because the columns are linearly independent, it's an invertible matrix. So we can write XB as B minus 1 times B minus N Xn. The vocabulary that we will use is the following. We will call the matrix B, the square matrix B, the basis matrix. And we will call the variables XB, so the variables that correspond to the columns that we have selected to enter the basis, the basic variables. And these are the variables that actually can be eliminated using this method. Now I suggest you to look at the example that we saw earlier in the video and to try to write it using this notation to identify the basic variables, the non-basic variables, what is the matrix B, and to see that this equation actually applies in this simple example. In this video, we have seen that some variables can be eliminated from the problem. To do so, we need to select M columns in the matrix A, such that they are linearly independent, and apply the formula that we've seen. Of course, there are many ways to select M columns among the N columns of the matrix A. So there are many ways to do this elimination. And most importantly, we should not forget that even if these variables are eliminated, the constraints that they are non-negative is not eliminated and should remain.